Here we are with DJ, my little four-year-old Canadian student. He's just finished his month of training today. In his education, he has learned lunging, work in hand, and Boucher flexions. And then in the last 3 days, I've added to his repertoire long lining. Why long lining? For one, his owner would like to do some long lining, but also I use long lining a lot with young horses. I use long lining to teach them directional, go right, go left, halt, trot, walk. So once he learns voice commands on the lunge, then I feel like he might be ready for long lining. I also use long lining to teach all the lateral movements. And again, I'm a very big proponent of teaching as much as you can to a horse from the ground before you sit on their back. So today I'm going to just begin with some work in hand, and then we'll do a little long lining. One caution about long lining is you must be very careful not to be in the range if a horse decides he wants to kick out, because some of them will. To start him, I began with very long long lines. Today, well, I will show you. Today I'm doing it a little bit different because I feel relatively good about his attitude towards long lining. Thank you. Okay, so with the long lines, you see I have them attached directly to the bit of his mouth. So this is the first kind of education for him to feel the contact that you would have with your hands through the reins to the mouth. And we're just going to do a simple forward halt, turn right, turn left, those kinds of things at the beginning of long lines. So those are the kind of very simple things we begin with long lining. Now I'm going to show you, we'll try to make an attempt at a couple steps shorter in on the long lines. Steps of shoulder in on the long line. Very good. DJ's final day in his first month of training here at Classicus Farm. So he's learned lunging, work in hand, boucher flexions, and a tiny bit of